Welcome back to The Ninth. So many of us grew up on the music of Gloria and Emilio Estefan, and their life story is as inspiring as their dozens of hits. Their journey together is chronicled in the musical On Your Feet. The show is now playing at the SHN Golden Gate Theater through October 7th. Excited this morning to welcome the music director of On Your Feet, Clay Ostwald, to The Ninth. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
There are two parts to this musical to me. There's the story, the love story, the success story, and then there's the music. Can we tackle the music first?
Absolutely. I'm absolutely privileged to be musical director of the show. And I play piano on stage, and we have 9 musicians on stage that are visible to the audience during the show when there's concert scenes and music scenes. And we have one musician, a drummer, who's off stage, and it's all live music, and the cast does a great job of performing the music. And we really have a blast every night doing the show. People are gonna be highly entertained.
It must be stunning to hear songs that I could probably sing by heart being produced live on stage by people who are also acting and dancing and hitting their marks. It sounds very complicated.
It is complicated, and we definitely have a great time doing all that, but there's a lot of moving parts, and there's a lot of dancing, there's a lot of excitement. But it's really more than just about the music to us. It's really an important show about the love story of Gloria and Emilio, the story of their immigration to the United States, and the challenges they had being accepted by a culture that wasn't theirs.
Right.
And remaining true to their own culture, but being integrated into the American dream.
The sound of their mother country, Cuba, is so evident in all of their hits. They were crossovers back at a time when there weren't that many.
Right. Well, one of the big crossovers that we pay tribute to a lot is Carlos Santana, who's right from this area.
Of course. He is.
And there's a lot of, you know, we have to pay tribute to all the people in the other cultures of the world who bring their music and their culture to our society. And I think in this political time and climate, we have to really recognize that importance. And we try to do that justice in the show.
Now, you spent decades in Miami. You were actually part of the original Miami sound machine.
Right. Well, 32 years. Yeah.
Got it. So tell me about what you witnessed in the relationship between Gloria and her husband as they became themselves as a couple and then became superstars, Emilio and Gloria.
Yeah, well, it's an amazing story, and in our showbiz society, to have a couple that are a lasting relationship and a wedding and a marriage that lasts this many years.
It's a
miracle. Just had their 40th anniversary,
oh,
by the way.
Oh, 40 years.
Yeah, it's an amazing story, and I've seen all those different eras of our and Gloria's career, and it's been amazing to see her go through all the different styles of music and pay all those cultural tributes to her career. It's amazing.
She is such a strong woman in a number of ways. I know musically her career went a little bit dark right around 1990. She had that terrible tour bus accident. I imagine that's addressed in the musical.
It is. Yeah, I was on a different bus that day, fortunately for me. But yeah, it's a big part of the story for sure. It's one of the big, huge challenges that she had in her life, and the story definitely has a big tells that story. Yeah.
What does she say about having her life portrayed on the stage live every night?
She loves it incredibly. She's incredibly proud of it. She comes out to visit once in a while, and we see her quite often. I speak with her pretty regularly, and it's very moving for her. Her and Emilio can't really see the show without shedding a few tears here and there. It's emotional, but she's been involved from the very beginning, from the storytelling to the rehearsals to the preparations to the music, and she's always with us.
And this is not one of those shows where you go and you sit with your hands folded in your lap, is it?
No, you go crazy. Yeah. And from the minute it starts till the very end, music's a big part of it, but it's a lot more than that for sure.
How can you pack 20 of her hit songs into a program that's relatively short to span her entire life? There's some, you know, juggling and stuffing in, I imagine.
Yeah, 2.5 hours is a lot. It's a very short time to tell anybody's whole life story.
Right.
But we try to do the best we can. Alex De Linares, the writer, and Jerry Mitchell, the director, Sergio Trujillo, the choreographer, did an amazing job of getting great storytelling and great music into a very short amount of time. But we have a blast in the show, and the audience is going to just absolutely love it.
I can't wait. Well, very good. Let's get you to see On Your Feet. It's playing through October 7th. We have all the ticket information you could need waiting for you on KTVU.com. You'll find it in the web link section under the Mornings on 2 tab. It is also on our mobile app. Clay Ostwald of On Your Feet, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Have a great time in San Francisco. We will be right back. And I will get on my feet. She's an incredible woman.